What I want to do in this video is give ourselves some practice constructing expressions with exponents to solve real problems. So let's start looking at these real problems. So this first one says the surface area of a cube is equal to the sum of the areas of its six sides. And that makes sense. If I were to draw a cube here, it has six sides. It has the three sides we see right over here, 1, 2, 3, and it has the three sides that we don't see. If we were to make this a transparent cube, then we could count those as well. So the one in the back here, one in the back there, and then the bottom right over here. So you have six sides of a cube, we believe that. Now this says Spencer has two cube-shaped blocks that he wants to paint. One cube has sides of length 4 units. One cube has sides of length 4 units. So let's say that this is this one right over here. So it's a cube, so all of these dimensions are 4 units. The other cube has lengths of sides 2.5 units. So the other cube is going to look something like this. The other cube looks something like this, and the sides are 2.5, 2.5, 2.5. Write a numerical expression with exponents for the total surface area he has to paint. Well, we could think about, well, there's six sides here. And what's the area of each of the six sides? So there's six sides like this. So there's going to be six times the area of each side. And what's the area of each side? Well, each side is going to be 4 by 4. Each side is a 4 by 4 square. So each side is going to have an area of 4, 4 squared. So the surface area of the six sides of this cube is 6 times 4 squared. Once again, the surface area or the area of each side is going to be 4 squared, and there's six of them. So that's the surface area of this cube. And then the same logic for the surface area of this cube. The surface area of, or the area, I should say, of each of the sides is going to be 2.5 times 2.5, or we could write that as 2.5 to the second power. And there's going to be six sides to the cube. So it's going to be 6 times 2.5 squared. So a numerical expression with exponents for the total surface area he has to paint, well, that's the surface area of both cubes. This is the surface area of the yellow cube. This is the surface area of the blue cube. And we are done. And just as a reminder on a little bit of the notation I'm using, this is not a decimal. This is higher than a decimal. It's kind of halfway up the numbers. And when I write it like that, that's a way of writing multiplication. And you're going to see that more and more as you go into algebra. I could have also written it this way. I could have written it as 6 times 4 squared plus 6 times 2.5 squared. This would have been another way to write it. And here, when you just write a number next to the parentheses, it means multiply by whatever's in the parentheses. So both this is 6 times 4 squared, this is 6 times 4 squared. So while we're constructing these exponent expressions, it's also good to get used to some of this notation. So let's do another one. In fact, let's do two more. Boomtown was established in a remote part of the world in 2010. Its population has tripled. Its population, let me underline that. Its population has tripled every year since its founding. If there were 1,050 people in Boomtown when it was established, let me write that down. So there's 1,050 people in Boomtown when it was established. What will be the population after 6 years? So remember, after every year, it triples. So after the first year, we're going to multiply by 3. We're going to have 3 times the population. The second year, multiply by 3. Third year, fourth year, fifth year, and sixth year. Or maybe an easier way or a more compact way of writing this is its population after 6 years is going to be its initial population times 3 to the sixth power. We have six. We're multiplying, we have 6 threes that we're multiplying together, times 3 to the 6th power. Or, just as we just talked about, the initial population, 1,050 people, times 3 to the 6th power. And the whole point here is not to evaluate these things, but just to construct the expression, to know that we could evaluate this and actually figure out the exact answer. But all they're asking us for is write a numerical expression with exponents, to describe the population of Boomtown after 6 years, and we just did that. Let's do one more of these. This is strangely fun. All right. So we have a square wall with sides of length 4 meters. Let's draw our square wall with sides of length 4 meters. So it's a square wall. I'm sensing a lot of squares in this exercise, or these exercises. So I have a square wall with sides of length 4 meters. So this is 4 meters, and this is 4 meters. And it has three square windows. It has three square windows. Let me do this in a different color. It has three square windows, each with sides of length 1.5 meters. So it might look like this. One square window, another square window, and another square window. And these are each 1.5 by 1.5. Lena wants to paper the wall. So she needs to determine the area of the wall that does not include the windows. Write a numerical expression with exponents that describes the area in square meters of the wall Lena wants to paper. So that's going to be all this stuff that I am shading in blue. Essentially the area of the larger wall minus the area of those three windows. And so what's that going to be? Well, the area of the larger wall is going to be 4 times 4. We could just write that as 4 to the second power, or 4 squared. The reason why people even call it 4 squared is because that's how you figure out the area of a square. 4 squared. And then you're going to subtract out the area of these three windows. So there's three windows. Each of them have an area of 1.5 squared. 1.5 squared. This area is 1.5 squared. 1.5 times 1.5. This area is 1.5 times 1.5. This area is 1.5 times 1.5. So you get 4 squared minus 3 times 1.5 squared. And there you go. That's going to be the area that she wants to paper.